I talked to other analysts who make a different kind of bet. Let's get to that in a second. Let's start off with a stock move, though, today, John. Obviously, the market down here. You see Apple under some pressure today. It's under pressure month to date, though, interestingly, not as much pressure as some of those other FANG names you guys have been talking about, which are clearly under more pressure. And that stock's still up about 30% year to date. As you mentioned, though, John, we're here today at this store outside San Francisco because of this. As you mentioned, the 10R is now available. It starts at $749. You're looking there at a 6.1-inch LCD display. This phone powered by that same new A12 Bionic chip. Other features, the advanced camera system, and greater battery life. Now, to your point, John, I did talk to Gene Munster of Loop Ventures, because now analysts start to take their bets about what is going to be the best seller. Munster's bet is that this 10R, John, the 10R is going to be your top seller over the next 12 months, because he thinks it does pack in a lot of value. That doesn't necessarily spell bad news, though, for iPhone average selling prices, because Munster's bet here is that when people do buy the new iPhone 10R, they're not going to buy just the base model for $749. He's going to gamble. They're going to pay up, right? They're going to pay up for the greater storage capacity, and that would obviously come with higher price tags. We'll wait and see. You know, the question for investors right now, is Munster right? Is the 10R going to be your top seller? If he is, what is going to be the model that they buy? That'll have a big impact on ASPs. And if there is demand, can Apple make these phones to satisfy it? Guys, back to you.